Now, what is your blueprint for classroom and student management? So you have to develop and design your blueprint. It's like, you know, architecture's, you know, blueprint for the construction and house floor plans. And so you, when you build your house, you know where the kitchen goes, and it's a, you know, it looks like, you know, floor plan. However, including your classroom design, you're gonna do later in the classroom management system. You're gonna make your own classroom management system. You have to understand your style, your characteristics, and your styles, and your personalities. It is very important because you are the manager of the classroom, and it is your classroom. Right. And even though you can include your students, invite students to your classroom designs and classroom rules and procedures, all that. However, still, you have your ownership to lead your students and then guide the students. So you have to know whole about yourself. So you are more like a permissive teacher. You are more like a democratic teacher, or you are authoritative teacher. It's all about your personalities and your, you know, characteristics. So if you cannot stand the children's a little, you know, talking, or you just you know, you can allow that, and you just rather do group settings, so it's all seating arrangement. It's just all up to the teachers, since you are the, you know, one going to lead your, you know, students and your classrooms. So these are all not just for your happiness. It is for the best outcomes of teaching and learning. So you can do your best to teach, focus on teaching, and then your students can focus on their learning. So for the successful, productive, and constructive life together. So it has to assure your productive outcomes. It's very important, right? So you have to think about how to run your classroom and what to expect from your students, and then what to do as a teacher, and then what to do as a student. So you have those in your mind and clear blueprint. And then first day of school, you share your blueprint with the students and explain them. Don't just think they are too young to understand. They understand. And then when you say, of course, you have to use the, you know, children's level, your student level language. And then you explain, we have to be happy here as a one family, and we're gonna work together. I'm gonna teach you well, and then you will learn well. So it's a reciprocally, we can be, you know, partners, and then we will succeed together. And then I really need you have to sit and stay in your seat when I talk, and then when you teach, you know, just classroom procedures and rules. And then when your teacher really teach important things, and then you really need to say something, you cannot hold, and then you just have a very, just like in the front chest, just raise hands like this. Only your teacher can see, and then I will see your hands, and then I will give you the sign, and then you can wait, and then I'm gonna call your name, and then you can share your, you know, thought, or you can ask questions. So it's as a one family. It's just important, right? In the family, and mom and dad, or just, you know, parents, they have their home rules, home policies, home rules. So parents expect every, you know, classroom family members stay in the dinner table until everybody finished dinner. And as a, you know, adult, home adult, you just said at the dinner table, everybody will say one thing about their day and then you share. It's like a round table talk time. And, you know, while eating, and then some families said, okay, it's just a parent culture. We do not talk while eating. So that is a kind of an old time Korean culture. While you're eating, you don't talk. And you don't show your, you know, food from the mouth and just be quiet and then finish eating. However, that's not really great, you know, culture. Because from the young age, children have to practice the thinking process because speaking is a form of thinking, right? So you logically, you can think and then your words, you know, comes out, you know, logically. So thinking and speaking are very directly, you know, related. So we see the children, you know, adults speak very well, very just like without the, you know, straight, they just focus on the topic and then very logically explain. And those speaking skills is pretty much, they may be formed from young age. And then in the family or schools, and they have a lot of, you know, discussion times. So discussion is just, you know, we have a topic and then we discuss, we, you know, propose our thought and then our thinking, and then we just form, and that's all from the head and thinking process, right? So higher order thinking process, higher order, you know, cognition, those just helps. So same in the classrooms, you can have those, you know, discussion times, and then once a while you have a classroom meetings. So everybody participate, and then everybody talk about their classroom business, and then everybody's, you know, behaviors, and then they can talk about the teacher's teaching, and they want to, you know, teacher cover this and that more. Even 5 years older and 6 years older, so in the beginning they may just shy and not talk, but later on children, you know, share. They just, because it's all about the atmosphere, right? Adults spread out. So everybody just can share their thought freely without judging each other. And then students feel comfortable, and then they just talk about, you know, their thought. So, you know, many kindergarten classrooms and first grade classrooms, they have just putting, I forgot the name of that, you know, but, you know, but it's a show, right? So they bring their favorite items from home, you know, and then they show, and then it's a tell a story types of, you know, in front of children, they just show their favorite, you know, dolls and just a teddy bear or just some, you know, toys they bring, and then they just talk about that. That's the part of, you know, practice. So if we have those kind of, you know, free talking time, and then your classroom, you know, can be more democratic classrooms, and then we just instead of your students think this is just like all teacher is kind of owner of the classroom and teacher lead everything, and then we are followers, so more like a passive, you know, learner types. Instead of that, teacher invite everyone to the table, and then they freely talk, like, you know, parents lead the, you know, dinner table talking, round the table talking, and then teacher could have those around the table talking, and then, you know, they can just modify, you know, this blueprint. However, September, that's first day of school, so in August or September, so new school year, teachers should have their blueprint first. And then they explain, and then 1 or 2 months, you know, we're gonna revise this one, and then everybody will be invited, and then you can just contribute to your thinking and thought. And then we're gonna make our new, you know, design, our blueprint, so you can do this way.